sustains my soul. I will sacrifice to you with willing heart and praise your name, O Lord, for it is good. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you always.
Amen.
Welcome to this beautiful Mass on this lovely day the Lord has given us. I drove back from the ordination this afternoon. It was great to drive without a cloud in the sky and the beautiful snow on our hills and mountains to accompany me. We have with us tonight Claudia and Oakley Mattingly down the front there. They are going to be receiving their first Holy Communion. They couldn't make it to one of the other days, so they are with us and their family tonight. So welcome to you all, and on this very special night for the children. It's a night where we are reminded of Martha and Mary in the Gospel. So when we hear the Gospel, we have to put ourselves into the place. Who am I? Am I a bit of Martha, or am I more of Mary? And I think the Lord asks us to be a little bit of both. So let us remind ourselves of those times we could do better and sit at the feet of the Lord. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord Jesus, we ask you this night to be with us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, we ask that we be more like a little of Martha and Mary from our Gospel. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
My Lord, he said, I beg you, if I find favour with you, kindly do not pass your servant by. A little water shall be brought. You shall wash your feet and lie down under the tree. Let me fetch a little bread, and you shall refresh yourselves before going further. That is why you have come in your servant's direction. They replied, Do as you say. Abraham hastened to the tent to find Sarah. Hurry, he said, knead 3 bushels of flour and make loaves. Then running to the cattle, Abraham took a fine and tender calf and gave it to the servant, who hurried to prepare it. Then taking cream, milk, and the calf he had prepared, he laid it all before them, and they ate while he remained standing near them under the tree. Where is your wife Sarah? They asked him. She is in the tent, he replied. Then his guest said, I shall visit you again next year without fail, and your wife will then have a son. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord, who shall dwell on your holy mountain? He who walks without fault, he who acts with justice and speaks the truth from his heart, he who does not slander with his tongue.
He who has justice for the praises of the Lord.
He who does no wrong to his brother, who casts no slur on his neighbour, who holds the godless in disdain, but honours those who fear the Lord.
He who has justice for the praises of the Lord.
He who keeps his pledge, come what may, who takes no interest on a loan, and accepts no bribes against the innocent, such a man will stand firm forever.
He who has justice for the praises of the Lord.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. It makes me heavy to suffer for you, as I am suffering now, and in my body to do what I can to make up all that is still to be undergone by Christ for the sake of his body, the church. I become a servant of the church, and God made me responsible for delivering God's message to you. The message, which was a mystery hidden for generations and centuries, has now been revealed to his saints. It was God's purpose to reveal it to them and to show all the rich glory of this mystery to pagans. The mystery is Christ among you, your hope of glory. This is the Christ we proclaim. This is the wisdom in which we thoroughly train everyone and instruct everyone to make them more perfect in Christ. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Into her house.
She had a sister called Mary who sat down at the Lord's feet and listened to him speaking. Now Martha, who was distracted with all the serving, said, "Lord, do you not care that my sister is leaving me to do all the serving by myself? Please tell her to help me." But the Lord answered, "Martha, Martha," he said, "you worry and fret about so many things, and yet so few are needed. Indeed, only one. It is Mary who has chosen the better part. It is not to be taken from her." The Gospel of the Lord. Action and contemplation, I suppose, would be the key words for our readings today. The reading from Genesis, the great reading of Abraham, starting the very extraordinary journey that he took with his family and his oxen and sheep and heading south down basically into Israel. And it took a while. And we have them in a tent. They lived in tents en route, obviously, before they could make permanent accommodations. And here they are, and it's a very famous scene where Abraham meets three people, and he doesn't realise that one of them is the Lord himself. And he offers hospitality, as everyone in the Middle East is very good at. And come in. You've been walking. You need to wash your feet, wash your hands, and we will prepare a meal for you. And they did that with simple bread and going out to the stock and getting something nice to eat, slaughtering it. And they probably would have eaten the flesh raw as well, because they still do that today. And there they are fed and watered and will either stay there or move on because they're journeying these three people to somewhere else. And it's that beautiful story of where Sarah is called. "Where is your wife Sarah?" Well, how did they know the wife's name from our reading here today? So one of them knew just a bit more than they should have. And Abraham said, "She's in the tent." Well, we shall return after this great meal and hospitality, and in that time she will have a child. Sarah was elderly, and just it's one more thing. So it's showing that from hospitality, beautiful things can happen. From there we move to our gospel, and Luke is the only one who has the depiction of Martha and Mary in this way in his gospel today. And as I mentioned at the beginning of Mass, we're all a little bit of each of them, but sometimes some of us are a bit more of one than the other. I think I'm a bit of a Martha myself. I got home today, I left on Wednesday because Do was having a few friends around, Hannah Do, and was having a few friends around, the Vietnamese crowd was turning up. It's a great house of hospitality because it has seven bedrooms, thanks to the Marist. And I said to Do, "Just leave everything, you're going on Friday, don't start doing the tidying up, just take off the sheets and on the beds and leave them on the floor so I know where everyone's going." And I arrived home about 4 o'clock and there are three loads of washing on the line already. Martha, Martha. And we're all a bit like that. But Jesus is arriving at this house, and remember, Martha and Mary's brother is Lazarus, the one he raised from the dead. So he knows this family intimately. Of the three times we know when he was gone to Jerusalem for whatever, he would always call in on the family. So they were well known to him and offered him great hospitality. And Mary obviously was always there to catch up on the news and what's happening up in Galilee. What are your last miracles that you've performed? Or we've heard this on the grapevine about what's happened. You just imagine what happened when he arrived. But we have this dichotomy of two people, one trying to do the best and trying to have an ear cocked to what's going on in there as well. And that's probably part of the problem. Whereas Mary must have thought to herself, we can deal with the food later. Jesus has arrived. Let's just sit down and hear what he has to say and learn even more from him. So our gospel tonight really is about the action and contemplation, and how each of us needs to be people of action in our faith, in our family, but also in the midst of all of that, people of contemplation as well. And that's part of what we do in our action. And sometimes our action is contemplation in itself as well. So during this week, let's try and remind ourselves each day of Mary and Martha, and what do I need to be doing better today in order that I can make the grade as a good Martha and also make the grade as a good Mary, both in prayer and contemplation and action in our faith. fullness we have received the bread we offer you, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the vine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father. Sacrifice brought to completion varied offerings of the law, accept, we pray, this sacrifice from your faithful servants and make it holy as you blessed the gifts of Abel, so that what each has offered to the honour of your majesty may benefit the salvation of all. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
Lift up your hearts.
Amen.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father of mercies and faithful God. For you have given us Jesus Christ your Son as our Lord and Redeemer. He always showed compassion for children and for the poor, for the sick and for sinners, and he became the neighbour of the oppressed and the afflicted. By word and deed, he announced to the world that you are our Father, and that you care for all your sons and daughters. And so with all the angels and saints, we exalt and bless your name, and sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Thank you. the mystery of faith.
Thank you.
take the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Father Michael Welsh's one for Claudia and one for Oakley. You're going to have to come up and shake my hand.
Congratulations on your big day. We'll have photos after Mass. There you go, Oakley.
I have Father Steve Barrett staying until Friday. You know Stephen, he's been here for a few times. And I also have Bishop Colin Campbell, who phoned up to say, can I have a bed for the night? So Colin's here as well. And unfortunately, we won't be watching a movie tonight as usual. He said to me as I was leaving, he said, Chris, he said, I think there's a bit of a game going on. Yes, Bishop, I suppose we'll have to watch the game. So we'll get you all home nice and early for the game. Let's stand and pray. Go the Irish. That's why I'm in green tonight, obviously. Let us pray. You're open the book again. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those you have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Now Mass has ended. Go in the peace and the joy of the Lord.
Amen.